Good afternoon. The first item of business is time for reflection. And our time for reflection leader today is Rabbi Aaron Lemberger, Assistant Rabbi at Gifnock Newton Mearns Synagogue and Jewish Chaplain for Glasgow and the West of Scotland Universities.
Presiding Officer, Members of Parliament, thank you for allowing me to address you today, shortly before my family and myself will be returning to Israel, our home, after 4 wonderful years in Scotland. What is reflection? Reflection is engaging in serious and careful thought, usually looking inwards. In Hebrew, this is called hitbonenut. But reflection is also the image one sees when looking at a reflective surface, such as a mirror or water. This is called in Hebrew, hishtakfut. Another word in Hebrew that has the same root as hishtakfut, reflection, is shakuf, transparent. The same root gives us two total opposites. Looking at something transparent is looking right through it, not really seeing it, like focusing on rocks or fish at the bottom of the sea, not noticing the clear water. Reflection is looking at something and seeing it plus finding ourselves in it, like looking at the water surface and seeing our own image. This past weekend, in synagogues around the world, Jewish people read in the Torah about the story of Korach, a cousin of Moses. This portion of the Torah is actually the same one I read in my bar mitzvah many years ago. Through this story, our sages teach us in the ethics of the fathers that every dispute, argument, discussion that is not for the sake of heaven will not endure. Which is a dispute that is not for the sake of heaven? Such was a controversy of Korach and all his congregation. When Korach and his followers challenged Moses about his leadership position and that of his brother Aaron, the high priest, even though they might have raised a legitimate point, they do it out of disrespect and envy. Korach looks through Moses. He is transparent to him, and he does not notice his reflection in Moses. Therefore, he despises him. This is an important lesson, the need to recognize the person in front of us when we argue or discuss issues on which we do not agree. Not seeing the reflection of the person can be the base for hatred, racism, and anti-Semitism. I know that during recent discussions on battling against and defining anti-Semitism, some of our Jewish students have felt unseen and harmed by not being afforded the opportunity to define what makes them feel vulnerable. They felt transparent. May we not be Korach. May we all remember to see our reflection in others. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Rabbi.